So what is going on, everyone? This is Fabi here. Now I know what some of you might be thinking. Haven't I done one of these videos back in 2018? Well, I have. I actually have done a review of the 2017 MacBook Air in 2018, but the fact is, back then, not even this guy, the 2018 MacBook Air, was released. So obviously the MacBook Air at that time was still the newest MacBook Air, even though there were other alternatives that had Retina displays, such as the MacBook Pro or the MacBook, but I would say that both of those would serve a different sort of purpose. You can't argue against the price of the 2017 MacBook Air though, so who is it still for? That's exactly what we're going to determine in this video. I'm going to tell you 5 people or 5 use cases that this MacBook Air is absolutely perfect for. Before we get into those use cases, I'm going to start off by saying that if you don't care about the screen, the MacBook Air is still plenty powerful for daily tasks. It's not a powerhouse though, but the MacBook Air was never meant to be one of those. Not even the 2020 MacBook Air is that powerful, and if you actually want something powerful, you can always go for the MacBook Pros. Whether the 13 or the 16 inch, both are going to be a lot more powerful than the MacBook Airs. So let's get into the first use case of this laptop. Let's say you're a writer, a student, or maybe an office worker. If all you need is to write on this laptop, to do office stuff, to write books, to write essays and stuff like that, the MacBook Air is going to be plenty powerful for you. Not only are you going to save a buck or two, you're also going to get some things that you don't get with a new MacBook. I mean ports, SD card, and even the old keyboard, which for some people I do believe it's better than the new one. Even if you don't think that you need the SD card, you can think of it as a cheap, albeit a little bit slow, external storage, which you can get on the newer version of the MacBook Air without some sort of dongle or something like that. Another thing that is great about the MacBook Air is the fact that it's still got the MagSafe power connector, and if you are one of those people that tends to trip over stuff, you're going to be grateful for those power connectors because it's magnetic and it just pulls right off when you trip over the cable and it doesn't take your laptop with it. The second use case for which I think that the MacBook Air is still great is, let's say you have a different laptop, maybe a MacBook Pro, and you want a secondary laptop that you can take with you on the field, let's say when meeting clients, or maybe you're a photographer, you just want to offload some pictures or video off of an SD card. Well, this laptop is great because, again, it has the SD card, it has ports, so when you're meeting with clients or offloading stuff off of SD cards, you don't have to be bringing dongles with you and look all silly like that. Not only does it have the ports, it's also very light, you don't have to panic about scratches because it's not new anymore, and it wasn't that expensive as, let's say, a new MacBook Pro is. A third use case which I can envision for this MacBook is if you want to have it connected to a secondary display most of the time, let's say watch Netflix or maybe do office work on it, but still have to be mobile from time to time, maybe take it to the office if you're working from home most of the time, or maybe you want to work outside sometimes. The reason why I think it's great for this use case is because it's pretty cheap and you don't have to look at its monitor that much if you're going to have it hooked up to a secondary monitor most of the time. The fourth reason why I think that this MacBook is still worth it is because some people just want to get into the Apple ecosystem, and getting an iPhone is great, but if you want the integration with handoff and other features that are exclusive between Mac and iPhones, you have to get a MacBook. And MacBooks can be pretty expensive, but not this one. So again, it's a great entry into the Apple ecosystem, and you're basically guaranteed to get a few more years of support out of this until you can spring for a more expensive laptop if you figure out that the Apple ecosystem is for you after all. Now, the fifth and final reason is for people that are looking into becoming app developers, whether for Mac or for iOS. Now, I know that there's tools out there to create Mac and even iOS apps for Windows, but I just don't think that it's going to be as seamless as creating them on a Mac, because obviously Apple has developed Xcode, Xcode Simulator, and a bunch of other tools which you don't have access to on Windows, and it just can't match that experience. But again, this is only for people starting to learn app development, or maybe people trying to experiment with apps, not for people that are looking into publishing apps that are very complex. Just as a closing note, don't get this laptop if you're looking into gaming. Even with Minecraft, it starts to stutter if you don't turn down the drawing distance. So again, if you're a gamer, just stay away from this laptop. Now, I do feel the need to tell you that this is not a full review. If you want to watch my full review on the laptop, you can check it out in the card that's going to pop up on the screen right now, and you'll be able to see just how fast it is in day-to-day tasks. You'll be able to see benchmarks and stuff like that, so I went pretty thorough in that video, and you can see all sorts of things about the laptop. Again, I'm still going to be recommending the MacBook Air to people. It's not the slow dog that some people think it is, or it's not this old sort of old-school laptop. It really is powerful for what it is. I do run a virtual machine on it from time to time with Windows 7, just so I can run some scripts in MATLAB, and it works fine. Anyway, if you're thinking about buying one of these laptops, whether it is the 2017 MacBook Air or the 2020 MacBook Air, I'm gonna leave links in the description down below to Amazon so you can buy them through my link. It does help me out and I would really appreciate it. Anyways guys, thank you for watching this video. Make sure to like it, share it with your friends, and subscribe. It really does help me grow on YouTube. As you've seen, I'm starting to be a little bit more consistent with my videos, so I'm hopefully going to be able to gain some audience. So yeah, thanks again for watching. Make sure to stay tuned. Peace out guys. Peace.